Good afternoon, everyone. So thanks for joining the session, TransTaps. So this is basically the first, introduction to TransTaps session, in which we'll cover some of the aspects of TransTaps, how we can use it, what it means, and the basic overview of TransTaps. So let's see, let's start with the session, introduction to TransTaps. So the first is like, what is the problem and the proposed solution? The problem was like, the problem is like translation position across packages for release branches with respect to current development and translation. So basically when we progress with the releases and different steps in different projects, say Fedora, so in that particular way, there are several packages being translated and some of them missed translation releases and some face unwanted delay. So this was the problem, and to cope up with the problem, the proposed solution is TransTaps, and TransTaps is an attempt to tie up the loose ends and maybe automate some of the localization steps in further phases. And the concept is based on syncing with translation platforms for statistics, comparing statistics with release streams, managing translation differences, keep up a stream updated, and create notifications. So these are five steps thing, and we have to go gradually with these steps. Currently we are stepping into comparing with the release streams thing, and we are almost, the syncing with translation platform for Zenata and Damplize is almost complete, and we are stepping into comparing stats with the release stream, just after integration of Fuji grid system and all. So, and thereby we'll be moving towards translation differences, managing translation differences, and keep upstream updated, create notifications. So these are the steps, and there are so many steps which has to be added to this particular list. So now let's move to how we can achieve this. To achieve this, we need to create a mapping between three things. First is upstream, translation platform, and releases. In upstream, we have identified GitHub and Pagura for the first phase, and in translation platforms, Zenata and Damplize. In releases, we have two different aspects viewing over it. First is schedule, and second is build system. Why schedule? So we need schedule in our system to create notifications, to have stats snapshots, so that we can have comparison between different schedule and what was the status in different schedules. To have work estimation of the coming release, like what is actual work estimation required, and the work estimation has to be generated for different teams, like for alternate team, what is the translation estimate for IATN and test QE team, what is the work estimate for things which has to be tested, and in development perspective as well. With respect to build system, it is very important step in TransTaps, like why we require integration with build system. So we require integration of with build system to have these many things, like translation differences, like the what is actual difference between translations which we have in translation platform, which is in upstream and which has been built through build system, that is Colibo Fedora. So we have to keep these three in sync as well, plus somewhere down the line we can invoke a scratch build with the latest translations by pulling latest translations from translation platform, and then we can send that particular notification to particular developer or package owner, package maintainer, that this is the build report for the latest translation, and if you are fine with that, you can go ahead, or we can create or push pull whatsoever might be required. So this is the actual mapping we need to have in place to create the system little or partial functional. So we have achieved some progress in this, and the things which are in green and orange things are in almost done and progress thing, and which is in blue in is planned. So basically build system is coming in progress, and GitHub and Pagura are planned. Rest of the things is attaining some stability. Now let's move to another demo part. So our demo instance has been deployed at transtaps.xyz. It is a temporary instance, and we'll take this down. Currently it is public, and it is a demo. demo instance, so it is just to try out things. And demo instance contains just one release, that is Fedora 27. And one can go and have a look on these particular settings. I have a small screencast recording. I did that when I was just configuring this environment. And may I play that so that I can explain in further details? So actually, initially we have three, on the initial landing page, we have three tabs. First is the status. This is for current status of all the packages which has been registered with TransTax. Second is coverage. Coverage based on different rules, and coverage totally means the graphs based on graph rules. Like these are the custom graphs which actually required by the developer or someone which can create a room for a custom graphs. And translation workload. So currently TransTax just have workload estimation for translation. So that is why we have tab translation workload. Now let's move further. So currently in translation workload depends upon the release branches. So this has to be added. Now let's select Anaconda, and these are the statistics which we get from translation platform, that is Zenata. And currently we have Zenata Fedora configured with this. Second is Gnome initial setup. These particular data is coming from Dandelion, the second one, that is Gnome 3.2.6. And this data is for this branch, Gnome 3.2.6 branch. And upstream, the statistics for upstream is coming from GitHub repo. Like what is the actual translation status of upstream? So upstream and this particular branch. Let's move further. We have systemd as well. In systemd, currently they are maintaining their own translations, and though they have one project at Dandelion, but still they are maintaining their own translations. So we are relying on upstream statistics, and that is almost 100%, except China, that's 99, that is also 100% tending to. So we can have these things in place, like the statistics from translation platform and upstream is currently being shown. Now let's move to graphs representation thing. This is more catchy, and this can show you the trends of different branches. Like suppose for Fedora 25, what was the position, and for Fedora 26, what is the position, and for the coming release. So this will show you the trend. You can see the trend in a particular language as well. Like this was the trend of different branches for different languages, and you can go back as well. Now let's see for Gnome setup. So y-axis is translation percentage, what has been achieved, and x-axis is languages. So here we can see that we are comparing upstream and Gnome branch for the language Russian. So here we can see actually the position of translation. And now let's go back to inventory and configuration. Inventory and configuration is very much important aspect of TransTax because it holds several data. And TransTax architecture is divided into three parts. The first part is inventory, which contains languages, translation platform, release streams. And the second step is jobs, these are some programs which are being run on inventories to generate some data, and those data are being represented in different forms, tabulars and graphs. So in inventory we have 10 languages, 10 active languages, 2 translation platforms, 1 release stream, 0 release branches and 14 packages. 5 jobs has been run as of now. Now let's move to languages tab. Yes, so in languages tab you can see that there are several languages configured, 10 are enabled. And these have locale plus alias sync. Alias is required to have sync with translation platform. Plus we can create sets of languages like master set and on level 2 sets we are there. Here you can see that we have 2 translation platforms, Dandelion public instance and Zenata Fedora instance. And in release streams, you can see that we have 1 release stream, Fedora only. In packages, we have 14 packages. These packages are currently mixed. Some packages are from Gnome, and some packages are do have their translation is in Zenata. So now you can see that we have sync status for upstream. We have sync status for translation platform. the current release stream for which the translation is being tracked, the mapping thing and settings button. So mapping is required to have some mapping between these particular releases. I'll show how the mapping works in some time. So now grapple stuff, to have different grapples which we can create. We'll create one grapple in some time. Logs, to have different logs of upstream sync, and these contain the general information like how the repo has been cloned and what PO files has been filtered and the statistics which has been generated from those PO files. Like for IOS it is 49, for Genome Control Center it is 172 PO files. These are huge PO files. PO files, I mean, there are 172 locales currently that package is maintaining. That is good.
So and, 172 locales?
Yes.
Oh.
Because we have 172 PO files. That means in upstream you have 172 locales.
Oh.
And let's register a new branch. So difference between branch and release is like we can have several releases like Fedora, RHEL and different. And in one release we can have several branches. Branches are releases of that particular release. So let's add one branch, Fedora 27. The system will take slug form, which is being displayed in the right. And we can attach one language set to particular branch. It requires an ICANN URL to have sync with calendar. So you can fetch ICANN URL from this particular page. Here we have ICS link. So just copy and paste that particular URL in system and add release branch. It will pass the URL, the data, and it will fetch out all the releases and dates. So here we have all the configurations. See that language set is all enabled. So Fedora 27 branch is currently mapped with language set all enabled, that is 10 languages. And sync calendar and track translation is enabled. Notification is disabled for this branch. Now let's move on. This is ICANN's URL which was added. In packages, let's add one package and we are adding about. So in the right hand side we can see that what slug currently a system is taking. We have to provide git URL so that it can clone repo. So this is git upstream URL. You can select translation platform and all the translation platform which has been added will be shown here. Select one release stream and add package. It will validate package from the translation platform. And then in settings we can sync it with upstream and translation platform. Currently abort is being cloned, all the PO files are being filtered and the statistics are currently being generated for abort. And actually those statistics as is are being stored in DB and we are just filtering the data we require. In logs you can see that 106 PO files has been filtered for abort. So upstream abort is currently maintaining 106 PO files. So we have sync, last sync flag there. And let's sync with transmission platform as well. So both has been synced. Now we can see the statistics for abort. In abort you can have upstream plus the statistics which we receive from Zenodata, the Fedora instance. Now let's go back and we are creating map. We are mapping branches. So branches, we have one release branch in transtracts, that is Fedora 27. So we have to map that particular branch with the branch, with one of the branches which we have from translation platform so that we can create mapping and we can map the statistics like this branch is responsible for this particular version or branch. So once we do mapping, it will map Fedora 27 to master just because it is not finding anything nearby. I mean, if we have F27 branch in Petaluma, something nearby, it will map to that branch. So most in Zenata or in other platforms, most of the packages are not maintaining Fedora branches, so that is why the things are getting mapped with master or head or something. So that is where we also have to create notifications to them. Now, since we have things mapped, I mean branch mapping is required, so now we have some branch map for some packages, we can see workload. So workload is, this is the total workload, like sum up of all the languages which is required for PyKit start. Currently everything is shown in messages just because from templates we are getting statistics for in messages and from Zenata we are getting statistics from in messages plus word, but by default the system is showing in messages. Now you can see here that for IBUS it is showing zero. This is just because branch mapping is not correct for IBUS. So I'll show you like how we can identify IBUS branch mapping. And we have to tweak branch mapping thing. I mean, we have to enhance that particular thing so that it can work in most of the scenarios. So we can just quickly go to IBUS and see. So currently, the this particular branch is not mapped with any of the translation platforms version. So you can see in IBUS that we have zero upstream and head. Upstream is for GitHub, and zero and head is coming from IBUS for IBUS. So that is why it is not mapped. In detailed view, we can have percentage which is remaining for different languages. This is more of a language percentage representation. In individual languages, we can see the statistics for individual languages. The first graph will show you like what percentage is actually required for these particular languages. Like, which is currently shown. So in Korean we have larger work, in Chinese traditional we have some work. So this is, and if we see in French, then it will show package and the messages which is currently has to be done. So we are almost done with Fedora 27 and there are so many messages yet to be translated. So this is like, here we can see that we can have some workload estimation. Now let's move to coverage thing. Coverage is depend upon rule, and you can create rule for a release branch and you can select some packages plus some languages. So rule name is RF installer. Let's say we are creating a rule for RF installer packages. We are selecting some of the RF installer packages and then you can select languages from this list or you can pick the mapped language set. So I'm picking the mapped language set and the graph rule has been created, like RH. You can see the overview here. Once you click on RH installer, it will take you to the coverage graph thing and it will generate a graph for you. So this is the graph in which we have all the packages and this is the stack graph. Like you will have an idea for the percentage which has been covered in each language for each packet for a particular release. So this is very much custom graph for a custom requirement, and hence it is termed as coverage. So now we have covered status, coverage and workload, all three. We are in process of development of client as well. So I'll show you demo of client, and we will be releasing this particular client in the next version, maybe by end of this month. And for the client, you can specify server's URL through environment variable, constat server, or you can give it in command line or in config file. So all three will be working. So I'll be using environment variable thing. Currently we have four commands. First is status, coverage, and version workload. So version is basically will show version of client and server. Status is for what is the current status of a particular packet. So let's say Anaconda. So transstat status Anaconda. It will just dump the JSON for all the branches which are currently shown as graph. This is the same data. And maybe we can have some flag for representation thing. We can change JSON to other thing. Or JSON is just for so that it can be consumed by some other services as well. So system D will have just one upstream levels merged, the norm initial setup. So hereby we can see the schedule of different packages in different particular view. These commands are just calling APIs at server, and what data they are getting, they are just putting that particular data on console. Coverage RH installer, we had created one rule, RH installer, and this will show all the statistics language-wise for each package. And the number is in percentage actually, the percentage of work which has been covered. So that is this is the coverage of that particular rule. And let's move to workload. So workload for Fedora. It will show an error just because there was a typo in Fedora. So yeah. So this is the workload estimation for each package, and this is detailed estimation, the sum of them, and the unit is messages. We can have help thing, like sub command and then help, and we can have details view of workload as well. So it will dump. Or like this is very detailed thing for all the packages. What is the workload for all the packages and for all enabled languages? So this is the statistics for workload thing. In different languages. In coming releases. So I think I'm done with the slides. We have some minutes left, so I'll open for questions. If anybody has. Yeah.
I love it.
Oh, thank you.
That's two things. The first one is to get the key from this training for every package in general. It exists a website, the name is release-monitoring.org. I think the technical name is Anitia. So maybe you can get some useful information about where are the key repository of each package. So it's going to take you like key. The second one is, can you store the PO file? Because there is also some quality checks that exist that we can run that are very useful for us as a translator. For example, it is consistency.
Right. So actually,
it's a kind of thing that I would love to see. It would be really great if you can get this.
If I can do. Yeah. So as I've mentioned that we are moving, like we are moving towards comparing stats with release streams, and then this step is managing translation differences. So in managing translation differences step, we have to keep POIs so that we can manage differences. So these are the steps I have identified, and the next step is that only. So we'll be dealing with POIs soon. Automated, sorry.
For example, in some languages, for example, French, you have some very particular space you have to add in many places that are very interesting to use. But to make your system clean, it's something that is useful. It exists some libraries that does that with the language, the language how to
thank you so much for the suggestions. Actually, we are also keep thinking on it, and the things you have mentioned, we have planned it to include in jobs so that we can have custom steps and we can write those steps by our hand, and the system will be playing those steps for us. So in jobs, we will try to cover these things, these steps. And thank you for all the suggestions.
From a resource perspective, so I think Alex was talking with the bet regarding hosting for Zanata. The same way for Transred, are you having a discussion with the Fedora infra?
Yes, we have planned discussion in this month. And
okay, makes sense.
So we'll start the discussion soon. Yes, this has been released already. Yes, this has been covered.
So normally we can run it here, from here.
Exactly. You can navigate to
first.
Sure. So I'll show you the link.
Can we do a workshop after the presentation?
I think yes, you can. I'll have to do
it.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes. So you can go to transstats.xyz currently. And yes, the things have been deployed. Plus, we can sit together and work that out.
Yeah, we got it.
Sure.
Okay.
So, may I close the session if we have?
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.